Good afternoon. I am Kritishnu, going to present our paper, Community Perception of Ecosystem Services and Its Valuation, a case study of Gaddi community in Himachal Pradesh. There are four kinds of ecosystem services. Since very long, we know that they are valuable. Now the obvious question comes, in spite of knowing it, why do we overexploit and allow the service providing natural resources to degrade? Because we can't capture their true value. Firstly, identifying all the services is too tough. And secondly, different stakeholders assign different values to the same service. So, comprehensive valuation of the ecosystem services is a must for a good management policy. Unfortunately, such studies are rare in India. In India, forest user right varies with the legal status of the forest. Each user community has their own perception about forest resource usage. Often they build a beyond materialistic bond with the forest. To frame a good management policy, understanding such perceptions are also important. Sadly, perception studies too are rare in India. Our study aims to measure the financial contribution of forest in the livelihood of rural people of West Himalayan region. So we needed a study site with high forest dependence. And as you can see, high forest cover, remoteness, and bad connectivity all have made Bharmur block of Chamba district in Himachal Pradesh a good spot for it. The villages were chosen by random sampling. We interviewed 60 households with a semi-structured questionnaire. Along with household and socioeconomic characteristics, we inquired about forest use, ecosystem services, management, and depletion. Also, through informal and free-flowing group discussions, we collected opinions from another 102 persons who were not from our surveyed households. We have used descriptive statistics and ethnographic techniques to analyze the collected data. Let's see, what have we found? People don't consciously remember what they collect from forest. The respondents generally mentioned fodder and fuelwood, but forget to mention food items. Those things are so obvious to them that they either forget or don't find them mentionable at all. This is what causes the underreporting. Other than some medicinal plants, everything is collected for self-consumption. Nobody has any idea about their prices. Now, if you look at the graph, you can see that other than supporting services, the people are well aware of every other ecosystem service. Naturally, provisioning is most important to them. The respondents' very high awareness about forest ecosystem services is one notable observation of our study. Forest products are altogether very important for the community's livelihood. Fuelwood and fodder are the most collected items. We have estimated that a household on an average gets a yearly benefit equivalent to 65,432 rupees just from the provisioning services of the forest. Now I am going to share a very interesting observation with you. What are the respondents' opinion about some quote-unquote illegal activities? The opinion is very much diverse, not the legality, but the community's perception dictates their opinion. Poaching is a regular custom and people are generally silent about it. Only after probing they confessed their silent support to it and the forest guards' active or passive participation in it. Interestingly, even the local environmentally conscious people also see no bad in it. The popular belief is there are plenty of animals or birds in the jungle. Killing some for food will not distort the biological balance. But they are strongly against illegal felling and forest land encroachment. Land encroachment is still somewhat tolerable because of the increased population pressure. But everybody demanded strong measures to be taken against illegal felling. So, what can be our final takeaway from this study? Forests are extremely important for Gaddi livelihood. Due to huge unintentional underreporting, an extensive valuation of forest ecosystem services is very tough and tricky. This underreporting comes from the obviousness of using those services and the practice of not attaching money value to these. The community is well aware of all ecosystem services other than supporting services. They have their own unique forest-related perceptions. Our study is very limited to offer any policy prescription. Still, looking at the forest user right and management-related conflicts all over the world, we can conclude that a comprehensive valuation as well as understanding of those perceptions both are needed to frame any successful forest management policy. Thank you. Now, I am asking for your questions.